The Charisma Book. Improve your small talk skills with charismatic communication. Written by Francis L. Eckart. Narrated by DMS. What is charisma? A fragile one is the word charisma. Several people, particularly scientists in different fields, have tried to answer the question, what is charisma? And there are as many charisma interpretations as there are people who have described it. The good news is that there is a common thread going through most of them, as varied as the meanings. Maybe that can help us better understand this characteristic. Therefore, charisma is most often described as a powerful magnetism that allows a person to easily connect with others and control them. Terms like beauty, elegance, and attractiveness are commonly used synonyms for charisma. Is the attribute that allows those around you to draw, impress, and affect. Identifying when someone is charismatic is usually straightforward. However, it is often much harder to say just what talents and attributes the other less inspiring people lack. There are various types of inspiring people to make things more complicated. Some may be louder, maybe depending more on their social charisma to manipulate others than their expressions. Others are enthusiastic communicators with their excellent overwhelming everybody. What does being extremely charismatic mean? A basic charisma concept is a seductive beauty or charisma that can inspire loyalty in others. In life, there are things we can change and things we cannot change. We learn from childhood that we cannot become an opera singer if we are tone deaf or an Olympic champion at the age of 70. We've learned to accept our limitations the way they are. Our greatest barrier to success today is actually going for the things that we want in life. Affirmations and meditation are some of the greatest gifts that the universe has bestowed on us. There are affirmations for almost anything that you want to change in your life. Those affirmations and meditations are what we'll be covering in this chapter and in other chapters to come, so sit back and be ready to get all the things that you want out of life. Why we quit all the time. Most of us barely start anything new from scratch. Before we start anything new, we have already reframed our minds to do so long before we put in the work to do that thing. For instance, if you want to go to college, you'll strain your ass off to study your college degree requirements or apply for internships before you actually commit to going to college. The same thing applies if you want to run a 100-mile race, a marathon, become an Olympian, a doctor, scientist, salesman. You have to build up to the event. Whenever we're feeling down, we completely forget the back end, all the buildup that you've done to get to the point where you are. You forget that we put in so much work to get where you are today. You forget the journey that you took to get into the current moment and make the right decision. You begin to tell yourself that we've won to continue again. You forget that as an Olympian, we had to run 2,000 miles to get where we were today. You forget all the 3 o'clock early runs that you did to win the 100-mile race. You forget that all the time you were able to get up early, to work, to beat the traffic jam, to get to the office in time. At the moment that you're feeling discouraged to continue the 100-mile race, you completely forget that you've only got 50 miles to run and you've already put in 6 months of training and done 60,000 to 70,000 pull-ups to even attempt the 50 miles you've just ran. So the best way to prevent yourself from quitting is to rewind your memory back to all the fucked up days that you were still able to run and do all the things you didn't want to do to get to this point that you're at today. The reason why you have to rewind your mind backwards is because if you haven't put in enough work to reflect on your past deeds, whether you're feeling discouraged, then you'll always feel as your life is screwed all the time because at that moment you've done nothing to pull yourself back up. That's why I always laugh at the people trying to use positive talk to snap themselves out of discouragement. Those people are using positive talk the wrong way. You see, someone who didn't study for an exam, telling him that he's going to pass the exam is just wasting his time. Making self-talk is all about rewinding your mind back on all the struggles you went through to get to the present moment. It's not about using self-talk to snap you out of discouragement. The human brain is a magical entity. How great is getting a machine that can make you happy, safe, and successful? A tool that can boost your quality of life dramatically, allowing you to learn, work, and grow yourself at lightning speed. A computer fitted with symptoms that enhances performance, stimulate drugs and medicines for healing. A device in which creative solutions, original ideas, and specific perspectives can be given. Wouldn't this be incredible? Okay, you should start smiling because for the whole length of your life, you have unlimited access to this amazing app. Via interactions and reactions in your mind, every memory, every thought, every understanding, every religious epiphany you ever had, no matter how transcendental it seemed to be, all your action, all you do, consciously or subconsciously, is done by your brain's demand. From keeping this book, chewing your food, blinking your eyes, and growing your hair, everything you know, understand, and recall, and even some stuff you have seem to have forgotten, have a place in your wonderful mind. Our brains have the most links of all animal brains on Earth, with some 100 billion neurons. While our brains account for only 2% of our body mass, they still use a quarter of the energy available. For most people, about 500 calories a day, the fuel equivalent in a whole bar of chocolate. Due to the high energy demand, it is critical that this system runs as efficiently as possible, perceives and adapts at the highest possible speed, and learns from the situations they encounter. Your brain was growing long before you were born, and new growth awaits you for every point of your young life. Gross and fine motor skills, vocabulary and perception, eyes, words and signs, ability to express yourself, identify things, and bond with your family. In each phase of life, the order in which these roles and abilities are formed is fully adapted to the different needs. Some gadgets experience wear and tear and become less effective the more they are used. But the brain only becomes stronger, more productive, and smarter as new stimuli and experiences test it. It has an organizational structure that can be learned from even the most successful companies through coordination, mission separation, and execution efficiency. Let's look at a rough three-way division of our brain, as the Turing brain concept explains it, based on the different roles and functions of our lives. The most primitive component, the reptilian brain, autonomously controls all sorts of essential life functions that you never have to worry about. From your heart beating and food absorption to blood cleansing and disease fighting. When triggering fight or flight in dangerous situations, this part saves your life on a daily basis and gives you the urge to protect yourself and your loved ones. That part of the brain gives you the instinct, intuition, and desire to live, from foraging for food to finding a compatible life partner. Your brain's mental limbic component consists of a variety of different structures, processes, and glands that function together to direct your long-term memory, motivation, emotions, and actions. This device is your built-in medicine cabinet, among other things. A chemical factory that manufactures and dispenses drugs when you need them. Of example, when you are in a threatening or stressful situation, this process controls adrenaline production, a hard drug produced and released by the adrenaline glands, which cause you to be more alert and have more strength, making you stronger, smarter, and quicker for a short period of time. Super quick powers. Melatonin is released at dusk falls, a substance that allows you to want to rest or go to bed. You get a soothing material when the sun rises so that you can start your day bright and alert.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.